Clear.
I think the answer should come from
a citizen of Americas.
All right, who is a citizen of Americas? All of them. What do you think over here of that question?
From my personal point of view,
a little bit louder, please?
Well, I don't think that none of the people that have come here to America are considered as outside agitators because what I can see, it seems though we're going to be better by them coming here. And before the sneak members start coming to America, I have heard a lot of citizens say that they wish that someone would come so that we can be helped, trying to gain our freedom too. And I really don't think that they're looked upon as outside agitators.
You see, before Don Harris came here to work on voter registration, there were very few Negroes registered. And really, he has helped us more than harmed us. You see, he, in a way, he became, Don is the type of person that everybody likes and looks up to. And he has really helped the Negroes. He has helped them. He has helped to open their eyes and to see them that they have been behind so long that the white man was act as if he was superior or something. You know, before Don came here, I think the Negroes in America just went along with whatever the white man wanted them to do. But actually, he got the Negroes to see that the ballot count and that they're human beings. You know, that each one of them should have a certain amount of human dignity.
You were speaking of voter registration, actually. Do you have any statistics on this as to whether the number of Negroes now registered to vote in America is greater than it was before Don came here or this organization got underway?
We have the statistics, but we don't have them with us now.
No, I didn't mean with you now, but I mean, could you give me a rough estimate as to what the increase in voter registration has been?
I think I might. Well, before a voter registration campaign was started here in January, there were virtually no Negroes registered here. In the county, the county is 53.8% Negro. But even now, there are only about 2% of the Negroes registered. But this is 2% more than were registered before.
What percent now? 2%?
About 2%. Maybe a little larger than 2%.
Can I make that
a little
clearer?
Yeah, come in. Before the drive was started, there were about 500 registered voters, the whole county.
500 Negro registered voters in Sumter County.
That's right. It has improved a great deal since the workers have been here.
You don't know how, whether it doubled or any kind of percentage?
No, but... there have been quite a few to go down and register, but I couldn't tell you.
What are the principal reasons why people hesitate to register to vote?
Fear. The Negroes were afraid, like when they go, if any people did go down to get registered, something was always wrong with the registrar, Mr. Chappell, the sheriff, would have something to say to him that the niggers, he would always say the niggers vote isn't going to count anyway, and actually the Negroes bear that in mind, that, well, what's the use of voting, it ain't going to count anyway. You see, the white man has taught them that for so long until actually they didn't know what to believe.
Mm-hmm. And there's fear of economic reprisals also.
How about that? Say a little word about that.
Well, any Negro that works in America works for a white man, and he has always got that fear of losing his job, even if he's not making the $12 a week. This is a great fear that is very hard to get out of these people. The boss man tells them not to go register, and they just won't go.
Is it fear of the economic or fear of the boss man, as you say, that would make the community hesitate to get into a real full-scale boycott or not? I've heard that the efforts at boycott, let's say, are not 100% effective around here. Now, why not?
Well, actually, I think they're afraid. You see, a lot of Negroes work for the people that own the stores downtown, and they're afraid to stop shopping in these stores because they know that they might lose their job. That's the only means of support that they have.
Well, let's just before this tape runs out, and I will in a minute or so, I'd like to kind of ask what you think inside you about what's going on. Do you feel that that it's going to be harder and harder to restrain the vigorous, able, protesting Negroes? Or do you think that there is a future for the kind of nonviolent resisting that is going on now?
Well, I think there's a future for it, but I don't know. I just can't answer that.
Bob, what do you think? Is it apt to move away from the nonviolent to more violent action?
Yes, I believe so. The people, especially in these black belt areas, look to the federal government for salvation. You know, you get no protection from the local officials. You get no protection from the local FBI. And just as happened in America's, when the FBI comes in, you know, and say that they find no evidence of police brutality, and the people there know, you know, that they are being mistreated, that they are being beaten,